हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल गोविंद नारायण पुरोहित, वेयर इन वी आर डिस्कसिंग द वेरियस टॉपिक्स ऑफ थीरियोजिनोलॉजी. एंड इन आवर टुडेज टॉक वी डिस्कस अबाउट वाटर बफलो रिप्रोडक्शन, गेस्टेशन एंड पार्चुरेशन. फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर गोविंद नारायण पुरोहित, द फॉर्मर डीन पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट स्टडीज एंड यूनिवर्सिटी हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वेटनरी गायनेकोलॉजी एंड ऑब्स्टेट्रिक्स, कॉलेज ऑफ वेटनरी एंड एनिमल साइंसेज, राजस्थान यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ वेटनरी एंड एनिमल साइंसेज, बीकानेर, राजस्थान, इंडिया. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द गेस्टेशन. वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट प्रेगनेंसी डायग्नोसिस एंड केयर ऑफ द बफलोज ड्यूरिंग पार्चुरेशन, आफ्टर पार्चुरेशन, ड्यूरिंग गेस्टेशन. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. नाउ गेस्टेशन और प्रेगनेंसी इज द पीरियड ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द यंग इन विविपेरस एनिमल्स from the time of fertilization of the ovum until the birth. And so from the time of fertilization of the ovum till the birth, the intrauterine development of the fetus inside the mother's uterus is known as gestation or pregnancy. As compared to cattle, buffaloes have a comparatively longer gestation period, delayed implantation, and the gestational length in buffaloes vary widely between the different breeds, 305 to 315 days in river buffaloes, and different types of buffalo, 320 to 340 in the swamp buffaloes. The placentomes of gravid buffalo uteri were arranged in four rows with a maximum of 102 in the gravid and 96 in the non-gravid horn. So for more details, you can just refer gestation and fetal development in the buffalo at the International Veterinary Information Service for a chapter on gestation and fetal development in the buffalo. But as far as the interest of farmers is concerned, the farmers are more interested in pregnancy and its diagnosis. Once they have got their buffalo inseminated, now they will have interest in knowing whether the buffalo has become pregnant or not. Now, pregnancy diagnosis in the buffaloes, there can be a large number of methods, but the most commonly used methods are the clinical methods, which include transrectal palpation and transrectal ultrasonography, and laboratory methods, which include the plasma or the milk progesterone and the assay of the pregnancy associated glycoproteins. Many other molecules have not become commercially available, although there are studies which mention that many molecules have been used for pregnancy diagnosis in the buffalo. Now, the non-return to estrus is the method used by the farmers. They got their buffaloes inseminated, and if it does not return to estrus, they presume that the buffalo has become pregnant. But it's our duty as a veterinarian to guide them, to educate them that they should get their buffaloes checked for pregnancy at 2 to 3 months of gestation for confirmation. Otherwise, if the buffalo is still in the season, then they can adopt therapeutic measures to bring the animal back into estrus and get it pregnant. So the clinical methods include the transrectal palpation, one of the oldest methods of pregnancy diagnosis in cattle, in buffalo, in mares, and it is considered a minimal invasive, you can say minimal invasive. One thing which one should keep in mind, that transrectal palpation in the buffalo must be gentle as compared to cattle, because the rectal mucosa of the buffalo bleeds very easily, right? Then transrectal ultrasonography can be used, and other methods are also available, which we discuss in brief one by one. Now, pregnancy diagnosis by using transrectal palpation, it's the one of the oldest methods, and it does not require anything except that the operator's skill is required, which will help in the diagnosis of the pregnancy. So that is the only thing which is required by the person for pregnancy diagnosis, right? When we talk of gestation, the first thing that a commercial person looks for is pregnancy diagnosis. Now, buffaloes are not like cattle, and they have to be restrained in a slightly different manner. Here you can see for cattle, the rope has been applied on the hind legs, and cattle will stand easily for an examination. But ropes are applied on the forelegs in the water buffalo, and then the buffalo is restrained. So it's easier. Then there can be another method of restraining the water buffalo, and if the buffalo is somewhat not cooperating, then you can tie both the forelegs and by tying a rope around the neck, and you can also tie the rope on the face, and then the buffalo would stand to be examined. So for pregnancy diagnosis, the easiest and the first and foremost method is the restraint of the buffaloes, and transrectal palpation is the method that is used very commonly for pregnancy examination in the water buffalo. Now, restraint of swamp buffaloes is also easy. A swamp buffalo is a very docile animal, you can see in this picture, and the swamp buffalo can also be made to stand in a travis, and then one can examine the buffalo for the pregnancy. Now, the easiest and easily available method of pregnancy diagnosis for buffaloes is transrectal palpation. The while performing transrectal palpation, the technician or the veterinarian, he examines both the uterine horns, and if there is the asymmetry, you can see in this picture, this horn is slightly bigger as compared to the other horn. Same is with this genitalia, this horn is comparatively bigger, fluid filled, and one can feel the resilient fetus also inside for pregnancy diagnosis. Then during the period from 4 to 7 months of gestation in the buffalo, one can examine the presence of cotyledons is also indicative that the buffalo is pregnant. And beyond 6.5 to 7 months, the fetus is palpable. So transrectal palpation is a very common and easier method which can be used anywhere at the farmer's doorstep, and one can examine the buffaloes very easily. These are some of the data which have been collected from different sources, and they reflect the length of the gravid horn at day 30, 25 to 25.25 centimeter, the length of the non-gravid horn 22.28 centimeter, the weight of the gravid horn, the weight of the non-gravid horn. You can see here the weight of the gravid horn is twice as much as the non-gravid horn. Then this will go on increasing, the length of the gravid uterus go on increasing with the advancement of the gestation. And so based on, and this is the length of the fetus or the crown rump length, one can know the stage of gestation in the buffalo. Then another method of pregnancy diagnosis in buffaloes is the transrectal ultrasonography. Transrectal ultrasonography can be performed in buffaloes very easily. You can just place the ultrasound on a table, and you introduce the probe inside the rectum after evacuating the rectum of the feces. The probe is usually entered inside a sleeve in which the gel is applied, or one can use a condom for placing the probe inside, and with some of the gel placed inside. Now, real-time beta mode ultrasound is a reliable and relatively simple method of diagnosing pregnancy in buffaloes as early as day 25 to 30. The ultrasonic Graphic appearance of different structures in different studies reveals that the fetus and the fetal heartbeat are visible at day 25 to 29, whereas other fetal structures become sequentially visible. In this ultrasound picture, you can see the fetus and the fetal heartbeat. Again, you can, in this one, you can very well visualize the fluid in the uterus and the fetus inside, and you can very well see the attachments of the fetus. Then, as this is, it depends on the placement of the probe and the position of the uterus, that if the uterus is slightly turned around or it's horizontal, then if you place the probe like this, then a picture will appear like this, and here you can see the fetus is visible in this ultrasound picture. Then the fetal limbs and other fetal parts will also be visible with the increasing days of gestation. Then you can visualize in different ultrasound pictures the different fetal structures, and you can see here the fetal vertebral column, and this vertebral column here, it is visible. This is the fetal vertebral column, and then you can increasingly identify the fetus using transrectal ultrasound. Now this table, it shows, then you can visualize the cotyledons. The cotyledons may have a central anechoic lumen, or they may not have a central anechoic lumen as this one. So these are some of the parameters which have been found in different studies. The embryo with fluid, day 22 in one study, day 20.5 plus minus 2.34 in another, fourth week, 19 days, 22.5 days, and in our own study, we found that at around day 26, the embryo with the fluid is visible in Surti buffaloes. So likewise, you can visualize the different structures using transrectal ultrasonography for pregnancy diagnosis. Farmers must be encouraged to report to the vet for pregnancy diagnosis within 2 to 3 months of insemination or of natural mating, so that they do not get losses out of rearing the buffaloes for pretty long time without being pregnant. So we should encourage farmers to get their buffaloes checked after 2 to 3 months for pregnancy. Then progesterone mill or plasma or milk progesterone assays can be used for pregnancy diagnosis in a buffalo herd, but the accuracy varies from 64% to 90% for the pregnant ones and 90% to 100% for the non-pregnant ones. And the specificity is 64% to 75% at day 21. The problem with the progesterone assays is the false negative or the false positive buffaloes, and another problem is that if the breeding season is over after mating, then that will pose a problem and identify falsely the buffaloes as non-pregnant or maybe pregnant. So then the high cost of the progesterone assays limit their use except on organized farms. Then the assay of pregnancy associated glycoproteins. There are reports that the early pregnancy detection kit like the Bioprin used for cattle can be used for buffaloes, and it can detect pregnant buffaloes from day 25 to 30 post insemination. Now there are some news reports wherein the Center for Molecular and Cellular Biology, Hyderabad, and the Central Institute for research on buffaloes, they have developed some kits for pregnancy diagnosis in buffaloes, but they are yet to be commercially available, for pregnancy diagnosis in the buffalo. Now, we talk of the care of the pregnant buffaloes. What we should advise to the farmers for care of the pregnant buffaloes? Pregnant buffaloes should be given ample grain fodder, and then because of high incidence of the prolapse during the gestation period, the floor where the buffalo stands should be raised towards the hind quarters, and it should be down towards the fore quarters. So that would reduce the incidence of vaginal prolapse, right? Now, during hot summer months, during very hot summer months, buffalo should be saved from direct sunlight, and they should be bathed in water twice a day. The floor for tying buffalo should be raised towards the hind quarters. Pregnant buffalo should not be forced to run. You see, the buffalo is running. They must be allowed only slight exercise, and stop milking buffalo 60 days before parturition. Then pregnant buffaloes should be separated from other buffaloes 2 weeks before the expected date of parturition. Pregnant buffalo should be provided 25 to 30 kg green fodder, 2 to 4 kg dry fodder, 2 to 3 kg concentrate, and 50 grams of salt, right? Then a common problem with the pregnant buffaloes is the vaginal prolapse, and this basically occurs because of weakening or relaxation of the constrictive vestibuli muscle and atony of the vaginal musculature. Then the increased maternal estrogen increases the incidence of prolapse in the water buffalo. Now, here we have summarized the different studies which used from 700 to 5000 buffaloes, and they found that antepartum prolapse occurring before parturition, is fairly common in the water buffalo. So, to reduce the incidence of prepartum prolapse, the quality of the feed and fodder should be improved, and the quality of the fodder be decreased. The prolapse incidence is very sparsely known for the swamp water buffalo. Then buffaloes with prolapse, pregnant buffaloes with prolapse can be managed using a truss. A truss like this one is placed here, and it's tied like this, it's shown in the figure, and then so that it prevents the vagina to come out when a buffalo is having contractions. Now, the care of the parturient buffaloes, 20 to 30 days prepartum, buffalo should be fed with wheat bran, linseed cake to minimize constipation. Buffalo heifers coming for the first time should be caressed with hand so that they do not pose a problem during the postpartum period for milking or handling. So they must be caressed with your hand so they are accustomed to. Then what are the signs of parturition? The signs of parturition in the buffalo, a buffalo from mid to late gestation gives some degree of discharge, and then nearing parturition there will be relaxation of the sacrociatic ligaments. You can see there is a dip here, and this will indicate that buffalo is near to the parturition. Other signs of parturition in the buffalo include the development of the udder, and you can see in this buffalo the udder is fully developed, and in this one also the udder is also fully developed. And some parturient buffaloes may evidence a slight diarrhea. Then what should be the care of the parturient buffaloes? The pre-parturient buffaloes may sometimes develop pre-parturient udder edema. You can see here the udder has developed a lot of edema, and this edema is not of much concern You can advise the owner to apply cold packs or cold water, and this will resolve once the buffalo has parturated, right? But if it does not resolve during the postpartum period, one can give some diuretics for resolving this edema. Then there is a problem of swelling in the teats. Farmers frequently ask what should we do if there is swelling in one of the teats. You see, if you have not dried the buffalo properly, there may be development of mastitis in one of or both or maybe all the teats. And for this, you just drain out the milk accumulated in this teat, and you can ask a vet to prescribe some medicine for infusion in the udder so that the mastitis resolves. But it should be a matter of concern, and animal owners must consult the vets. Then parturition in the buffalo is similar to cattle. The buffalo, you can see here, the udder has fully developed. The buffalo will look anxious. It will switch her tail to one side, and it may get up and lie down. And then finally, the contractions, when they start, then the first water bag would appear at the vulvar lips. The first water bag would appear and rupture, and then the second water bag, which is grayish blue, would appear, and this will rupture, and the fetal limbs and the head of the fetus will come out. So these are the signs of these are the signs of parturition in the buffalo. Now similar signs have been recorded for the swamp buffaloes, and a swamp buffalo may parturate sitting, or it may just get up, and the limbs of the fetus along with the head, they come out, and then the animal completes the second stage of parturition, that is the fetal delivery. Now there are frequent questions from farmers and veterinarians alike that a buffalo is parturating, the water bag is ruptured, how and when to pull the fetus. You see, it's pertinent that if the second water bag has ruptured, you must wait for half an hour, at least for half an hour to a maximum of 2 hours. And if the fetal delivery is not progressing, then you can assist. But it usually happens that farmer, when he sees this type of scene, that both the limbs are coming out, he just pulls the limbs. And this is not proper, because the fetus will pull his limb back, and this may lead to deviation or flexion of the limb. And many a times the normal delivery is converted into a difficult birth. The fetal limbs traction should not be applied on the fetal limbs until unless both the limbs and the head are out. Then there are questions that buffalo has completed gestation but has not parturated. For how much time one must wait? The gestation period of the buffalo can vary from 310 to 315 days, and sometimes some buffaloes may require 2 to 4 days more than this also. So if the buffalo has not completed or is not showing any signs of parturition after this time, he must consult the veterinarian. Sometimes it so happens that buffalo shows signs of parturition and then the parturition signs recede. This may occur when the buffalo is suffering from uterine torsion, or it is having some other clinical problem. So one must consult the vet, and if this much time has completed and you have known, you already have a record of the service or artificial insemination of the buffalo on that time, then it's not advisable simply to pull the limbs without the head. If the head is there, then of course you can pull the limbs, but simply pulling the limbs is not advisable, and pulling one limb is not at all advisable. Then the common delivery problems with buffalo could be, the most common delivery problem is uterine torsion, which we are not discussing here. We have a separate lecture on uterine torsion in the buffalo. But other delivery problems, the most common one is flexion of one of the limb. Until unless this limb is straightened, then the buffalo will not deliver. And you will find in the clinic, many a times buffaloes are brought with one of the limb out, and it's not advisable to pull this limb without straightening the other limb. Also, the head is important. The head should be straight, and if both the limbs and head are out, then of course you can pull the fetus. Then another common delivery problem is the lateral deviation of the head. If the is not sufficient time has passed, then one can put his hand inside and grasp hold of the mouth of the fetus and straighten it. But if sufficient time has passed, then there the uterus will contract, fluids will be lost, and then you will require other aids to correct the head. But until unless you straighten the head, it's not possible to take out the fetus. So this is a common fetal delivery problem, lateral head deviation. Then rarely one can find the breech birth. In breech birth, the hind legs are coming first, and the forelegs and the head is towards the diaphragm of the mother. So when these legs, they will have the hooves on the opposite direction, one can identify this. And then if both the legs are in the birth canal, the easiest way is to apply ropes on both the legs separately and pull it out, because this fetus will easily come out if the legs are straight. But if the legs are deviated, or it is a hawk deviation or bilateral hip deviation, then one will have to correct this before pulling the legs, right? Then after parturition, the buffalo should be allowed to lick her calf, as this will and then you can many a times find the placenta of the buffalo hanging out of the vulvar lips. The buffalo must be allowed to lick the calf, to lick her his or her navel, and this will stimulate the circulation in the fetus and will stand up. Then after parturition, the perineum and udder should be washed and feed the calf with colostrum. It's always advisable to feed the calf with colostrum as early as possible. Feed the buffalo with jaggery, green fodder, and energy rich diets. Fresh, clean, and lukewarm water should be provided to the buffalo. Then placental expulsion. The usually buffaloes expel placenta within 2 to 8 hours, and buffalo should be washed, especially this area after expulsion of the placenta. Any disinfectant can be applied if there are scratches on the vulva or on the perineum. Then it's common for the farmers to break the hooves of the newborn calf or buffalo calf. Maybe if you do not even break them, then they will shed off once, because they are very soft, they will shed off when the calf will stand up on the ground. Then what should be the time for manual expulsion? You see, it varies from 8 to 12 hours. If after 12 hours also the buffalo, and it will depend on the season when buffalo is coming, if the placenta is not expelled after this time, one must consider for manual expulsion or other therapies, appropriate therapies. Now, there are frequently farmers asking that should the buffaloes be milked if placenta has not expelled? Of course, the buffalo should be milked if the placenta has not expelled, because milking will evoke the secretion of oxytocin, and this will help in expulsion of placenta also. Then there are chances when buffaloes may eat their placentas, and because the placenta is a muscular mass and it is not the food for the buffalo, it may cause digestive upsets. It may sometimes cause toxemia to the buffalo, and therapy including the administration of antihistaminics and also the administration of antibiotics if desired, and the purgatives so that this placenta does not cause much harm to the buffalo. But one should take care that the buffalo does not eat the placenta. Then there are questions that what are the signs of abortion in the buffalo? If the buffalo is showing tenesmus, contractions, frequent getting up and lying down, discharge of mucus or blood, it must be suspected that the buffalo is going to abort. Now, frequently, animal owners, they administer a dose of progesterone to buffaloes that show signs of abortion. This is not at all advisable. One must check if the os externus has opened, then it is always better to allow for the abortion to occur instead of stopping it by giving a dose of progesterone, right? Because otherwise, when you stop it, then that it will convert into fetal maceration, and that will be problematic for the buffalo, right? Then frequently, the after placental expulsion, abortion after abortion, placental expulsion may take a longer time, especially in diseases like brucellosis. And brucellosis is prevalent in buffaloes. And when a buffalo is aborted, the material should be submitted to the laboratory for examination and for finding out the cause of abortion. Right? Now, what should be the care of the aborting buffaloes? Immediately separate the buffalo that is aborted from other animals, and to save other animals from getting the infection, probable infection that the buffalo might have developed and that has caused the abortion in the buffalo. Then the postpartum complications in the buffalo. The most frequent postpartum complication in buffaloes is the metritis, which has got a high incidence, especially if the surrounding is poor and the parturient hygiene is not proper. And then retained placenta is another problem, whereas postpartum genital prolapse is very less frequent as compared to other problems. And then pyometra is also very less common as compared to cattle. Then postpartum hemorrhage, a buffalo showing a hemorrhage like the one shown in this figure, it must be treated vigorously. Maybe if there is a rupture of some cotyledon, or maybe rupture in the uterus, and it is advisable to administer some ice packs, oxytocin, and maybe the methyl ergonovin malate, calcium. But if the bleeding does not stop, one must investigate and ligate if any bleeding point is visible using a speculum, and then ice packs may be used for stopping the postpartum hemorrhage. Then postpartum metritis in buffaloes is evident by discharge of foul smelling and discharge from the vulvar lips, sometimes pus like discharge. And the buffalo frequently keeps his tail to one side, and if these signs are developing within 10 days, one must treat the buffalo with systemic antibiotics and other appropriate therapy. If it's developing beyond that period, one can think of intrauterine infusion of antibiotics and other medicines as the clinician seems appropriate. Things appropriate. Then care of buffaloes with hypocalcemia. Hypocalcemia, a buffalo may turn his neck to one side, lie down, and buffaloes with fever because of metritis or because of some other reason, they must be treated immediately. You immediately call your vet so that he comes and attends the buffalo. He institutes appropriate therapy so that the buffalo does not enter into grievous condition and is saved. Buffaloes with metritis often have low production, and they are off feed, and they may sometimes even rarely develop laminitis of the legs, and buffaloes with hypocalcemia, they may show a low body temperature, and they may put their neck to one side, and other signs specific to hypocalcemia might be evident. Now, you can see in this table that we analyzed 286 cases for buffaloes with milk fever, ketosis and parturient hemoglobinuria from 2004 to 2013, and we found that the maximum incidence in the buffalo was for ketosis. Buffaloes may develop ketosis and also parturient, more than that was parturient hemoglobinuria. But hypocalcemia is very less common in the buffalo, as we could find in the clinical analysis of 286 cases of buffaloes presented to our clinics. And buffaloes responded very well to administration of 25 to 50% dextrose, triamcinolone and sodium acid phosphate for parturient hemoglobinuria. Right, so if you like this video, kindly, this is my contact. You can contact me at my email gnpobs@gmail.com, and this is my YouTube link. You can approach the YouTube channel and visualize the different lectures, give your suggestions, give your comments, give your likes, and share the video, and subscribe to my channel Govind Narayan Purohit if you like it. So have a nice day, and all best wishes to all of you. Thank you. Bye-bye.